Welcome to this week's vlog. On this week's vlog, we're going to be talking about an amazing system that's called the self-charging hybrid system. Yes, you heard me right, a self-charging hybrid system. Now, if you've seen Toyota and Lexus's adverts, obviously Toyota owns Lexus, they have gone for an amazing self-perpetual motion device called a self-charging hybrid. Yes, they have a hybrid that completely charges itself. What an amazing piece of technology. I mean, Newton would be proud. They have basically broken all the barriers of physics and invented a device that completely self-charges. Now, if you see Toyota and Lexus's advert, it clearly says they've chosen a device that charges itself and does not require a plug. Yes, that's right, Toyota have chosen not to put a plug on their hybrid. No, theirs self-charges itself. Now, if you weren't aware, Mercedes... Yes, right under here is Mercedes' self-charging hybrid battery. Yes, you heard me right. Right under here is a 12-volt standard... Okay, it's time to drop the sarcasm. Obviously, Mercedes do not make a self-charging hybrid, but also neither did Toyota. It's time I get technical for the first time ever in my videos and explain the full difference between different cars. So, obviously you've got an ICE combustion car, which is a pure petrol or diesel car, runs on combustion fuel 100% that drives the wheels. We all know what they are, they've been around for decades. The next car is what we call a battery car, BEV. A battery electric vehicle, which basically means the whole car is powered purely by electric. So that includes the Renault Zoe and obviously the Nissan Leaf and all the Teslas. We then have a REX, which is a range extender. This has an electric motor and it also has a small engine. The engine charges the battery and the wheels are powered by the battery alone. So basically, even though it has an engine, a combustion engine, the combustion engine is there to facilitate the energy of electricity, so therefore it's more efficient. The engine is tuned to run at the most efficient rate, and therefore that's why BEVs are actually not that bad. We next then move on to hybrids. Now, a hybrid car works a bit like a Formula One KERS system. It constantly recharges the battery from the motion of regenerative braking. So same as what your electric car does anyway, all electric cars have regenerative braking, but a hybrid car regenerates just purely from that energy, that lost energy. It runs purely, mainly on the ICE engine. The ICE engine is the main form of that movement, and it uses the petrol of the ICE and the driving, normal driving, to repower a battery that then gets put back into the wheels. It's more efficient than an ICE, and it's better for the environment than an ICE, but it's not as good as the other two that I've just previously mentioned. We then move on to a PHEV. Now, this is a PHEV, BMW i8. A PHEV is a vehicle that has a plug. The plug powers a battery. The battery powers the wheels. Now, being a PHEV, it also has an internal combustion engine, which also powers the wheels and also charges the battery when the battery runs low. The idea of a plug-in hybrid is you can select to purely run off the battery. London taxis are PHEVs, Outlanders are PHEVs. A PHEV is obviously a lot better than a normal hybrid because if you wanted to, you could run it purely off the battery and never use a combustion engine as long as the range was in the battery range of the vehicle. They obviously have a much smaller battery than full BEVs, but they're a lot more environmentally friendly than some of the other options that you can get. The question is, where does Toyota's system fit in? Would you say it's a range extender, which is what it sounds like, a self-charging hybrid? Sounds like a range extender. It's not a range extender. It's also not a plug-in hybrid. It's also not a full BEV. It's also not self-charging. What it basically is just a hybrid. It uses the ICE engine and then almost like a KERS system, like Formula One, like I mentioned before. It's using the motion of the wheels of slowing down regenerative braking to charge a little battery, which then puts a couple of miles extra range onto the ICE motor. Yes, it's better for the environment than a full ICE, but it's certainly not a self-charging vehicle. And it certainly shouldn't be advertised as one. There is nothing wrong with the term hybrid. Hybrid just means exactly what Toyota have got. Their very, very first electric car was a hybrid. They called it a hybrid, and now they've invented a new term called a self-charging hybrid, which is just a way to mislead people and consumers into buying vehicles. I find it confusing, so someone who doesn't work and sort of study the electric car industry is going to find it even more confusing than I do. Now, the reason I've mentioned all this is I want you to go down the description below. There's a link to the Advertising Standard Agency, and I want you to report Toyota for their really basically trying to take advantage of customers' poor knowledge of electric vehicles. Now, I've not got any problem with a hybrid which doesn't have a plug. I've got no problem with it. It's better than an ICE car. So before everyone starts putting in the comment, "Oh, you shouldn't say this," yes, it is better than an ICE car. I've got no problem with that. My issue is the confusing advertisement that they're using, and they're doing it on purpose. I think it's deliberately misleading to fool people into thinking that it's got some sort of fake collection energy device. It's very poor practice of Toyota. They know exactly what they're doing, and they need to stop it. Now, you might want to know why I was making the little joke about the 12 volt battery on the Mercedes. The reason for that is self-charging hybrid gives the impression that a battery that charges itself up. Now, a 12 volt battery on any ICE car charges itself up from an alternator. So does that mean that all ICE cars are self-charging hybrids? No, it doesn't. So really what Toyota should be doing is just calling it a hybrid like everyone else. Thanks very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to click here to become a patron, click here to subscribe, and check out my other videos down here. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.